afternoon. We're gonna do a little yin yoga this afternoon. All of my online yin classes, we're just doing 6 poses for 5 minutes each. I forgot to get my iPad to time that, so I have to do it on my watch. But we'll just hold, like I said, each pose, 5 minutes each. You do your best to stay in the pose, resisting the urge to come out of it so that your body gets the benefit. So we will start. There's a playlist if you have any interest in listening to music. I'm not listening to any music. I'll just kind of enjoy the outside sounds. But we'll start just however you want. Come to a comfortable space on your mat and just let your body relax. Find a little stillness. As you come to that comfortable space, just start to breathe a little deeper. Sending that inhale. And exhaling out, however you like, through your nose or through your mouth. Making that breath deeper. You'll use that full deep breath as you move into and hold your poses today. We're going to come into our first pose. So it's either child's pose or I'm going to move you into melting heart from child's pose. But you'll want to sit back on your heels. Your knees can be close together or far apart, but you're sitting back on your heels. Your body is resting on or between your legs into child's pose to start with. Now, if you want to stay there, that's great. You can stay right there in that child's pose with your arms forward or even reach around for your heels. Or you can bring this into melting heart, lifting your hips up, walking your arms forward, and you're going to sink your forearms, your chin down. If that's not comfortable, placing your chin to the mat, you can turn your head to one side or the other. But just kind of settling in here. If you're coming into melting heart, it's also called puppy. So think about what a puppy looks like stretching. And you want to try to relax everything from your rib cage down as you settle into that pose. Thank you. right to melting heart, sitting back into child's pose. You can move next into pigeon. You can take the upright version of pigeon, or you can lie on your back for reclined pigeon. That right ankle crosses over your left knee. You can pick your left leg up if you like. I'm going to come to the upright version of pigeon. It's whatever is a good fit for you. Squaring off those hips, folding forward if you like. If you need a little more in this upright version, you can bring your torso toward the front left diagonal like you're smashing your foot. Or you can thread the needle here. Left arm can reach underneath your body. Right arm can wrap behind your back, trying to catch your right big toe. I'm just going to take regular old pigeon right now, right down the center. If you're in that reclined version, you don't have to pick your left leg up, but you can. Just find some stillness there. Big stretch through the entire right hip socket and your glute, and possibly your left hip flexor if you're in this upright version. release from that pose. If you're in that reclined position, just let go of that right leg. If you're upright, you're just going to come up with your upper body. We're going to come into half or full saddle with your left leg back. So if you're on your back, you can just tuck that left leg in. It's okay if your knee is up off of the ground as long as it's not hurting your knee. You should feel that through your left hamstring. If you want to do full saddle, take both legs back, sitting between your heels. We'll do full saddle again when we do the opposite side too. So whatever fits well with you, otherwise it's left leg back. Full saddle is a pretty intense back bend, so that may not be in the cards for you today. release from that. Make your way out of that pose, and then we're gonna switch sides, taking those two poses on the opposite side. So if you're on your back and taking reclined pigeon, cross that left ankle over. If you're upright, left leg in front. Find my timer again, making your way into that pose. You need a little more, you can move your torso to the front right or thread the needle, right arm under, wrap your left arm behind you. to make your way into half saddle with your right leg back. If you did full saddle last time, you can do full saddle again. Or if you're with me, I'm going to take a full straddle. Got to get a sweatshirt here. You can lie down first and then tuck that right leg in. Or just take both legs back. If you want to take full straddle instead because you did full saddle last time, just come right down the center. Does it matter if you're in straddle, if your knees roll forward, your feet roll forward? Does it matter? pose. We have one final pose. We're going to take it into a seated forward fold. It's called caterpillar in yin. So make your way up to a seated position with your legs straight in front of you. They can be together or slightly apart. In this pose, sometimes it's nice to elevate your hips. You can sit on a blanket or even a towel, especially if your hamstrings are really tight. It's also a good option if you have something to put around the bottom of your feet, like a hand towel or a strap. Otherwise, you're just going to let your body fold forward over your straightened out legs. Head can hang heavy. If that's too much tension, lift your head up. You can even stack your hands, rest your head in your hands. You can stack things to put your head on. You just want to fold forward into this pose as much as you can to where you're sort of comfortably uncomfortable. This is our final pose. your way onto your back. And once there, just sealing up your practice however you need. Taking any final movements or poses if you want a spinal twist or happy baby. Just ultimately coming to your final relaxation, giving yourself some stillness, some time to just relax in a comfortable space. Bringing some movement back to your body. Ultimately making your way up to a comfortable seat. We'll breathe in together, arms reach high, hands to heart as you exhale, with love and gratitude, from my heart to yours, namaste. Thank you all so much, hope you enjoy your evening or your day whenever you watch this.